Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making deep-fried potato wedges, and I started on these last night. It's not a complicated recipe, but it is helpful to you if you get a little bit of head start because there needs to be some cooling of a cooked potato before you brown it up and have your nice crispy potato wedge. So I started with some potatoes that just came in a bag like this. These are russet potatoes and we use them for baking a lot. They have a good texture for baking. So this is just an example of a washed potato that you definitely do want to wash them. And then what you need to do is pick out as many as you would like to have and put them in boiling water, which I salted. It's up to you whether you want to do that step or not, but I would go ahead and salt the water, maybe 1 teaspoon, maybe even more than that, to get some salt taste into the potato. And you can divide them in half if you'd like to and cook for less time. I just did them whole and it took about 25 minutes for them to be done. And I use a fork to test and see if it's tender. And when it's tender, then you need to drain off the water and then let them cool at room temperature for a little bit and then cover them and stick them in the refrigerator for overnight. And then that's where we are right now. Just gotten these out of the refrigerator and I've been working on some. This is a cold cooked potato. So what I'm going to do is take a chef's knife and just slice down through it, dividing it into two equal parts. Now we want wedges, and if you just quarter it, I think that's a little too big, so we're going to divide it into thirds. So you need to kind of go toward the central point, angle your knife in, and make one third, and then you can leave it sitting there and angle in this direction to make your other third. So you have three pieces there that you'll be able to put into your hot oil. Now over here I have some peanut oil and I have about an inch and I've been heating it up so it's probably about ready. I'm going to finish this last cut on the cooked potato. So we have a wedge here and then another wedge here. Now I'm going to test just one of these, and it's nice to have a slotted spoon, or in this case is a kind of a flattened round surface for me to work with, and we'll just take one of them over there and see if it's going to start frying. If it's not, then I don't want to put all of them in because they would soak up grease but not really fry well. Yes, that's fine. That's what we want. So I'm going to bring the whole tray over, my cutting board actually. And it'll be easier for me to make the transfer from here. But I don't want to just plop them in there because that hot grease can spatter back up. And you have to be really careful when you're working with hot oil. Just let these slide into that hot oil. And do enough until you feel like it's crowding them a little bit and then stop because you don't want to have too many at one time. And just let them brown up. That's what we're trying to do is get a nice crispy potato. That's just a wedge part of the potato and it's a nice substitute for french fries. You can use it in the same way you would french fries with hamburgers or steaks, or you can just have them as a munchy, crunchy dish and dip them in ketchup or whatever and eat them as potato wedges instead of french fries. So we'll give these a minute or so and then I'll stir them with this to see how we're doing. And I'll be taking them up when they turn a little bit golden brown. And you may be here to see it or I may have to do it while I'm away. But I will be back in a minute to show you what we're getting. Well, that was quick. It's very quick for them to brown up like this. They're nice and crispy on the outside. And the first thing I want to do, this is a little bit hot, but not too hot. But you know they're cooked all the way through because they were cooked last night. But what you want to do is to grind a little bit of Atlantic sea salt over them. Particularly if you did not salt them earlier. And now I need to tend to this next batch. And you can see how they brown pretty quickly. It's not a problem at all to get these done. So these are not really quite ready. I think I'll just go ahead and cook all of these. I know you get the idea. And I'll come back and we'll serve them onto a nice plate. Just waiting for this bunch to get done, and it looks like they are. And I wanted to show you bringing out a bunch and get them all on one slotted spoon. If you try to let any grease that you have drip back into the pot if possible, and then place them over here with the others. And then we'll be putting these in just a second. But there's a mark. Rick pointed to one that I missed, and it's a little bit light, but it needs to come out too. Okay, I try to immediately get to the salt and give it a good sprinkling because that seems to soak in right at that point very well. Now I'll finish these up and I'll show you the completed dish and I'll talk a little bit more about it then, but I have a few more to fry. I got the last frying of the potato wedges out and I'm going to give that one last shake or grind of sea salt. Use any kind of sea salt that you want, or kosher salt. What we have here are 5 potatoes of the size I showed you, and they were each divided into 6 pieces in the way I showed you. So that gives you 30 pieces, which is a big plate of potato wedges. Now you'll notice that I did leave the skin on. If you don't like that, then you can peel your potatoes before you cook them. Cooking them is very important because it's really difficult to get something this thick done in the deep fry situation where you're browning up the outside. But these, as soon as you brown up the outside, you know it's done all the way through because you cooked it already the night before. So let's take one of these and I'll let you see what the inside looks like, and then I'll take a bite and tell you what it tastes like. It looks like a nice mealy baked potato inside, and I have a little bit of ketchup over here, so I'm going to just dip that in and we'll take a little bite. I'm tasting a lot of ketchup right now. But the taste of the potato is very good, very crunchy on the outside and a nice smooth taste on the inside. Just a hint of salt, probably from the outside more than the inside, but tastes really good. I think it's a real winner.